You have entered the Plumbing Business Success Zone, teaching entrepreneurs the business of plumbing. This is Potty Talk Live, recorded live every week. Turn on notifications to never miss an episode. Now your host, Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber.
Hey, plumbing pros, welcome to the 330th episode of Potty Talk Live. Hey there, I'm your host, Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber, along with my co-host, the lovely Laura, where we're talking the business of plumbing, how to systemize, monetize. I'm trying to think off the cuff here. It's been one of those days here, but it ain't working out. Hey, we're having a great time here.
Works, baby.
Hey, if you're a plumber, stick with the script. That's what she's telling me. Stick with the script. All right. No, I like to go off script.
Oh, yeah.
I like to color outside the lines.
I know you do.
Okay. Babe. We're going to talk a little bit about that tonight.
Hi, Andrew.
All right. Hey, got a great episode for you here.
Okay.
I can't wait to get into this one where we're talking the laws of success.
Yes, there's a law.
There's a few laws, but the laws of success,
okay,
which also could be the laws of failure. I mean, there's always a, you know, both sides of the coin kind of a thing here.
Okay.
But there's some good stuff here.
All
okay.
Right.
If you're looking to be successful, okay, with your plumbing business, or if you're trying to figure out why you're a failure.
Golly.
I mean, one of those moves.
Oh, boy. Hey, Jacob.
Right. Wow. Stick around. You don't want to miss this episode of Potty Talk Live. Hey, we already got a checking in live.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, it's good to have you, all of you here live, part of the live social audience.
Steve,
good to see you, brother.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, do that. Hey, if you're with us live, part of the live social audience, please type live in the comments. Let us know that you caught us live here.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, if you're watching the replay, let us know you caught the replay by typing replay in the comments. And if you're listening to the podcast, you know what to do. Just keep on listening.
All
right.
Long. Hey, Alex.
Okay.
My favorite ball.
Kelly Ball. Hey, it's good to see everyone. How's everyone doing?
Hey,
I'm feeling
Scott.
Good.
I'm
feeling good.
Aware of that.
I know. I just, I kind of went off script. Off script here. I work on a script. We have stuff here. But I just, what comes,
wait,
you know.
Look who's in the house.
Bobby. All right. Jersey boys.
Hey, Bobby
is live in the house.
And Cleet from down under in Australia.
All right. You out of the house?
Yeah, Cleet.
Oh,
house,
man.
How's things going down under?
Come on, guys.
Praying for you guys.
Yeah.
Hey, April.
Man.
I'm a plumber's life. A plumber's life. Is
all right.
In the house.
All right.
Plumber's life. Okay,
good.
There we go.
All right. Good to have you here.
Good to see everybody.
Love Live. Nathan.
Nathan.
Good to have you here, Nathan.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Johnny Castillo.
Johnny.
Hey, look forward
Cherry
to talking.
Cherry Blossom Castillo.
Yeah. Cherry.
That's such a great name. I can't
Cherry
wait to see
that. Is. That's going to be cool.
Yep. Yes. Christine Vocolo. What?
Oh, good to have you.
Hey,
the Vocolo.
Christine. Tell me your wonderful husband. We said hello as well.
Yes. Thinking of you guys.
Okay. So Pretty Lance good. Is pointing out your T-shirt. So let's get a look here.
Yep, I know.
Well, the mic's kind of covering it up.
I know. Not today, Satan.
Wait, pull off the comment. There we go.
Not today,
Satan.
All right. Mm-hmm. I was born to smack Satan upside the head every day, and so are you, brother.
So are you.
So are you, Lance.
Yes.
All right, and my other brothers out there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you were created to knock Satan upside the head.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Trey Society is live, live, live. Hey,
all right.
Joe
good to have
Martinez.
You here, Joe. All right.
Everybody checking in.
We got a lot
that.
Here. All right. It's good to have. Hey,
Larry Logan, the third.
All right.
Where's the second and first?
There we go.
I wonder.
Hey, but Larry, stick around here. I can't wait to get into stuff, the laws of success. This is important stuff.
Okay.
Important stuff.
It's very important.
To your success, okay? The laws of success,
okay?
We'll get into it here. But question first.
Question, we have a question
okay.
for you.
Okay, kind of deals with the law here.
Okay.
Okay, what happens when you break the law?
Okay,
what happens when you break the law?
What happens?
What happens when you break the law?
Okay.
Okay, let us know.
Yeah,
okay?
What do you think happens?
I don't know. What do you...
Have you ever broken the law, baby?
I've been on the other side of the bars.
Oh, let's not talk about traffic, like ran a red light or sped.
And we know you have.
Okay,
I mean, a few times because you beat me.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, see, most people don't know what we're talking about. So
okay.
There's a rumor.
Hey,
anyway.
We all have haters.
Haters gonna hate.
Hey, by the way, your plumbing business, you know when you're succeeding, when you start getting, you know,
people
the community
hate
of people start hating you.
Right.
Okay. For every one person that hates you.
So, baby, we've made it.
All right. That's right. Come on. All right. So, yeah, we have, you pay the price.
Pay the price, Alex.
You do. There is a price to pay.
There is a price.
Okay. All right. Depends on the law.
Depends on the law.
All right.
That's very true. Is it a misdemeanor or is it a felony?
Okay. Mm-hmm. It depends on exactly.
Go into hiding. Of course you do, Aaron. Oh,
I can see that. As I'm getting to know Aaron, I get the humor.
Go into hiding. So, okay, we're going back. Have you ever broken the law other than your basic traffic laws that you break daily?
Yes. Now, what I learned from this lesson, on a personal lesson, you know, I had one day when the sheriff showed up at the door when I was 17.
Okay.
And for a warrant for my arrest.
Ooh.
Okay.
Okay.
And what had happened, I had turned left. Well, you weren't allowed to turn left. I was on a date.
Mm-hmm.
So I really showed her a good time. and I got a ticket.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought that I could just show up. You know, I could just pay the ticket.
Okay.
Whatever. But there was a court date because of my age. You know, I had a court date. Well, I didn't show up to court.
Oh.
So the court had a warrant out for my arrest. Okay. So one day, the sheriff, got knocked at the door.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, officer. You know, and he literally took me a ride in the back of the car and everything.
Really?
And it was there in the cell, the holding cell and all that.
Did you fingerprinted?
And I'm doing all the stuff.
Wow.
Yep.
And that's out there now.
So, So my haters, all right, hey, if you're gonna at least, you know, pick something that is right.
Well, they didn't.
Never mind. Okay, at least it's in the neighborhood, you know, that I murdered someone on this. I got arrested because I murdered someone.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
This is all right.
But I get in front of the judge, and I'm just a 17-year-old kid kind of shaking in my boots and all, and telling a story. And, you know, here's what wisdom, you know, law, there are some judges that have wisdom, okay? And he just looked at the situation and basically, you know, just said, look, kid, there's no excuse for not knowing the law. So just because I wasn't aware of the law.
Ignorant of the law.
Or ignorant, right. Ignorance is, you know, no excuse.
No excuse.
Right. Mm. And so, long story short, he let me off, okay? I didn't even have to pay, even the ticket or anything.
Mm-hmm.
Or whatever, it's like a lesson, you know. But what he did, I remember this to this day, you know, the judge sitting up high, he was meant to be a little bit of a, you know, a little bit
intimidation.
Of a intimidation,
sure.
Right? You know, saying that ignorance is no excuse for the law, okay?
Okay.
And so it goes, same thing goes with these laws, okay?
Ignorance is no excuse.
Just because you aren't aware of them doesn't mean that they don't exist.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like, you know, the law of gravity. I don't know how it works or whatever, but just, you know, if I step off a cliff, I'm going to drop,
right.
You know. Well, I wasn't aware of that. It doesn't matter.
You are now.
Right. It still happens. Right. So there are laws, okay, and they were created, okay? There are laws, and you've heard me say, I always end, you know, the program saying that you were purposefully, wonderfully created, okay, which you were. You didn't crawl out of the slime, okay? Our universe just didn't just go, and here's the universe, and now we have all this going on.
Right.
Okay, that's a great lie,
right.
Okay?
Correct.
All right?
We were created by
a creator, God, okay, who loves you very, very, very much, all right? And he also created this earth, okay, and these laws, okay, they are in place for us, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So there are laws that do affect our ability to succeed, or, sadly, a lot of us are working laws to our failure.
To fail.
All right.
And you're going to point out if someone's a failure.
We're going to point that out. Okay.
Right.
All right. Are we ready?
Sure.
Okay. Do you want to get at it?
Yeah, I guess
okay.
So.
We got any questions? All right. Good. Thanks for joining us. All right. All right. Let's find out. What are the laws of success? Let's hit it. Okay.
Okay. Let's hear it.
Laws of success. Mm-hmm. Number one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the law of attraction.
Okay.
Now, many people have heard of been out there.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of, the new agey people and all this kind of glummed on this, the feel good stuff, the law of attraction.
Right.
Okay.
Kind of leave God out of it.
But, yeah, leave God out.
The creator.
Which the creator said, we were told, and, you know, by the creator, you know, all you need is faith of a mustard seed.
Which is tiny,
you know, which is a little small seed, and you can literally move mountains.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right. That is a law. What we thinketh, we beeth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, or can achieve it. Okay, all right.
Kind of
very good. A little King James in there. All right, that's Richard one.
Things.
You know, too.
The Book of Richard.
The Book of Richard.
Oh, blasphemy!
Okay.
The
Book
right
of the
there.
Million Dollar Plumber. Okay. No, but the law of attraction, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And really, this works. I work with our, you know, in the academy, I mentioned this kind of part, and we also work with our clients.
Mm-hmm.
I've done it for years of writing down my daily GPS,
yes.
You know, that I am, I have,
right.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Not that I will, okay?
Right.
But
so it's not necessarily goal setting, it's projecting.
It's projecting. Mm-hmm. Very good, all right?
Wow. Well,
yeah, those big words, all right?
Projecting
you're clarifying. I'm a plumber.
Making clarifying statements.
Okay. All right.
All right. Baby.
So we can project. Okay. What we think on.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Does happen. Okay. You know, so we can either think positive things, which mm-hmm. is really what, you know, on the success side of things. Mm-hmm. Sadly, a lot of people think of failing
right.
things.
Worried.
What right. This is going to happen. You know, what if the economy goes down mm-hmm. or what if, you know, I'm talking on the business side of mm-hmm. things, you know, I can't.
We don't have calls for a few days.
Right. I can't find anybody.
Right.
I can't find any customers. Right. Don't call, mm-hmm. you know, all these negative kind of things.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We project that out mm-hmm. and look what happens.
Because mm-hmm. we're focused on it.
Right.
What do we talk about? Because we lived in Indiana for almost ever.
Yeah.
Indianapolis 500. And you talk about racing. What happens?
Right. Well, I heard this, you know, a lot of, you know, when you watch like these racers on the mm-hmm. Indianapolis 500 circuit, mm-hmm. they literally come in with inches of the wall at 200 miles an hour.
A billion miles an hour.
Okay, Sarah says, found my dream house, going to project it into my...
Oh, I can't wait to hear about that, Sarah.
All right, and let's talk about it. Mm-hmm. This isn't, you know, just, you know, this isn't, you know, prosperity kind of gospel.
No, prosperity gospel or
kind of stuff.
Name and claim it.
Right, that
no,
kind of stuff,
it.
Right.
No.
But, you know, I heard it from this race car driver is being interviewed, mm-hmm. okay, and you know, was saying, you know, aren't you nervous? You know, don't you wear the wall? You're coming up with inches of the wall. Doesn't mm-hmm. that scare you?
Right.
Well, the winners aren't looking at the wall.
Mm-mm.
They're looking at the line, what they call the line, into the turn,
the
way down
turn.
In the next turn down the straightaway.
The
mm-hmm. You're looking at the future.
Correct.
Because
exactly.
if you look at the wall, you wind up going to the wall.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's just obvious.
What you look at.
Right?
Well, it's the thing of the guy's riding a bike or you're skiing or whatever, and if you look at the tree, what do you hit? I mean, it could be the one tree.
You're hitting the tree.
The one tree. You're going to hit it, mm-hmm. all right? Because that's what I'm looking at.
Mm-hmm.
You project it. Right.
It.
That's where we go. Okay, but the same thing works in a more positive manner.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, if you will visualize that your plumbing business is successful, and mm-hmm. you define that. What does that mean?
Right.
Okay, that I am a million-dollar plumbing business.
Mm-hmm. I have 10 trucks.
I have 10. Right. Mm-hmm. I have 10 trucks,
I have
and
a
they
shop.
Look a certain way. Right.
Mm-hmm.
I have these kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
We see it happening with our clients
literally every
other day,
yeah.
where we got guys. You know, a year ago they were flat. Broke, busted.
Mm-hmm.
Now they're in a big shop,
mm-hmm.
and they got multiple trucks,
right.
and that kind of thing.
More money than
all right,
ever thought possible.
Right,
mm-hmm.
and it's
because they focused on that.
They
right.
look towards that.
Right.
Okay.
They look at the fear, and there's plenty of fear to look at.
Right.
Right. Always
right.
scared to look at. Always.
Hey, mm-hmm. Carrie.
Carrie.
I was a track runner. So
mm-hmm.
was I. And one of the biggest things I learned mm-hmm. was to visualize yourself winning.
Mm-hmm.
It was
such a motivational boost.
Yes,
yeah, absolutely.
Exactly mm-hmm. right, Carrie. I so relate to that because I was a track runner as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you had to visualize yourself crossing the line first.
Right.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
I would visualize. I ran the 400. I don't know what you ran. You fit what you run up. I ran the 400.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so I always visualize taking guys in the turns. I always mm-hmm. visualize the last turn. Of passing guys.
Mm-hmm.
And so I saw myself doing that kind
so
of thing.
So you didn't stand on the line and look at the guys and go, oh, man, I'm never going to beat this guy.
Right, this is so-and-so or whatever,
mm-hmm.
and man, I'm right. And,
yeah.
and visualize myself coming in, you know,
right.
third or last or whatever.
In the dust.
Right, or afraid of that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Because truly what you focus on happens,
mm-hmm.
okay? We see it all the time. We
mm-hmm.
see it outside. People focus on being sick.
Mm-hmm.
They're sick.
They're going to be sick.
They're going to
mm-hmm.
be sick.
Yep.
That's why. Well, I don't want to go down that road. But if you visualize, you know, if you see yourself as a sick person,
mm-hmm.
you're a sick person.
Yes.
Okay. If you see yourself as a healthy person,
mm-hmm.
it's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You focus on the things that then help you be healthy.
Right. Okay.
You put those in
if,
play.
If it looks the way you look at life,
mm-hmm.
2 mile to mile. Right?
Wow.
All right, Carrie.
Gee whiz.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. You definitely have to, you know, what you know how you focus. You
mm-hmm.
know, if you focus at, you know, everything's out to get you.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's out to get you.
Well,
as Henry Ford said, what you believe is.
What was his
famous? You know,
it's a good one.
Right.
I can't remember,
you know,
it will come to me.
Right, as a man thinketh in his heart,
so is he.
Proverbs. Job.
Exactly.
Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
Mm, Proverbs.
All right.
That's a good one, Job. Proverbs 31. There's 31 books of Proverbs, right? 30.
I read them,
right.
Joe. I read Proverbs every morning.
That's
this morning
great.
I read. I'm in like the 21st chapter, 21st,
mm-hmm.
or so. I'm right near that area
mm-hmm.
there. We talked about you know, hanging around with an angry man, you'll become angry.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same kind of. You know, it's
mm-hmm.
just, you know, if you're thinking that way, you
mm-hmm.
develop that thinking. All right, that's what you become.
Yes, I was going to say that's a great book to read every day. Just or yeah, every day read.
I read.
I read Proverbs every day, especially during these times.
So wisdom. Everyone
know what
needs
wisdom
some
is.
Wisdom.
Okay, right. To keep it on track. Mm-hmm. The wisdom, mm-hmm. not some guy in a lab coat that just wants to make a bunch of money. Mm-hmm. Wisdom. Okay.
Right.
All right.
The wisdom. Okay. So
okay?
Law of attraction.
Law of attraction. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Number two. Mm. Leads us to the next part. I kind of mentioned here. Mm-hmm. Here, okay. The law of association. Mm-hmm. The law of association. Mm-hmm. All right.
You're the average of the five people you hang around with.
All right. Who said that?
Jim Rohn.
Famous
all right. motivational speaker. If you guys never heard of Jim Rohn, R-O-H-N, I think. Is that how you spell it? Great motivational speaker.
Check out YouTube.
Yeah,
Jim
YouTube. Just check it. Some older stuff.
He's like the original of the motivational.
Yeah.
Not one of the, I mean, there's some others that are a little older or whatever, but mm-hmm. of the kind of the new era. That's where Tony Robbins came from.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so
kind of stuff.
Great motivational. But, you're the average of the five people you hang around with the most.
Right.
So take a look at the five people you hang around with most. You're the average.
Hey, look, if you hang around guys that are just never have money, you're never going to have money.
Or always just want to drink and party.
That's what you'll do, all right? If you hang around losers, you're losers. Look, that's why this is one of the difficult things, because if you are truly looking to better yourself, you got to hang around better people than what you've been hanging around.
Right.
And see, that can be difficult because these are my friends. I've grown up with these people. This is who I party with. This is who I do whatever with.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to be where they're at?
Do you want to be, there? Mm-hmm. All right. Okay.
Do you want to stay where they're at? Did they start a business? Can they support you and be encouraging for you in a plumbing business?
Right.
Normally not. That's usually just not the case.
Right. Mm-hmm. You know, it's this law of, association. Mm-hmm. It's so key.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
So getting around other business owners, there's all kinds of groups in your area. BNI's, there's which is Business Network International. There's some good BNI groups. Other ones, not so much. So it's kind of a hit and miss. Chamber of Commerce or Rotary or something to where you're around other thought leaders or other business people in your community. Okay. If you've just had a baby, then you're off the hook. Let's just say that.
And part of who you're hanging around with is who you listen to.
Mm.
So, if you're watching nothing but news today.
Fear porn is all that is.
Fear porn. Even if you're watching all the sports stuff. Mm. I mean, guys, you're hanging those,
If you know all the stats of all your favorite whatever team.
They've done well to hook you in, all right, to keep you low, okay?
Angel says this is why we plan on making our visits to Florida so much more frequent.
Yes.
Absolutely, because we want to hang around with good people like Ron and Angel Blevins out on the boat. Out on the boat.
So it's so important, what you put in here, who you hang around with.
That's why with our Success Academy, there's a great group of people on the Facebook group, and then we have the twice a month live coaching.
Right.
I'm good to hang around with others, asking good questions, and we can learn from each other.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If you're looking, even with us, we're looking, it can be a little, as a guy, that's kind of an alpha guy that feels like I'm in control. I want to be in control.
Right.
I get this.
I
want to be the top dog in the room. Right.
Baby, you are the top dog every single time.
Yeah, baby. All right. And you're a good wife, but it's, you don't achieve by being the top guy in the room every single time.
You don't want to be the smartest guy.
You don't want to be the smartest guy. Okay. Mm-hmm. You don't want to be, it's like even like working out.
Mm-hmm.
I want to work out around guys that do better, lift more,
pushing,
who have better, looking better.
Mm-hmm.
There's a reason why I don't hang out with certain. we're of that age, and sadly, of the age that we're at, all the guys just look, older and wore out. And I'm getting old. I don't mind getting old. These are jars of clay.
They are jars of clay.
But I want to hang around guys who, even guys of my age and older, who take care of themselves.
Yes, absolutely.
Right? Mm-hmm. Who don't say, it's just time,
let it all go, yes.
Right.
Lisa said we always teach our kids to hang around people who you want to be like in 10 years. Pick people who are 10 years older than you. Oh, that's good. Yes, that's so smart.
Yep.
Good parent right there,
yep.
Lisa. That's the other McKinsey's.
Yep. Very good.
Yes. Teach that with your kids.
It's so important.
To your kids. Matt says he loves your shirt. Not today, Satan.
That's not today, Satan. and smack you upside the head every day. All right? You were created to smack Satan upside his head every day.
Every single day.
All right? We need more guys willing to smack Satan upside the head every day and not just go along with the program.
Yeah.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of a program, I got a free program for you.
You're so good, baby.
Okay? Free program for you. It's my Million Dollar Plumber Blueprint, okay? In it, all right, I have all the specs that you need to build a successful, self-sustaining, and very profitable plumbing business, okay? I lay the specs all out, just like a blueprint. You know, you can roll it out, okay? When you roll it out and look at it, okay? And these are the specs you need to get. I mean, I tell you exactly what you need, okay? All right, to build a house of bricks, not a house of straw, or a business of straw. All right? All right, where the business demons can come in and huff and puff and blow it down, all right? You have these in place. All right, you'll have a strong business. Mm-hmm. And it's free. Did I mention it was free?
I don't think you did.
Okay, it's free. Simply type free in the comments or go to themilliondollarplumber.com/free. All right, and grab it.
This day, this very day.
All right, the laws of success. Mm-hmm. Okay, number one, the law of attraction. All right, number two, the law of association. Check. Got that one, check, check. All right, and finally, number three, the law of action.
Ooh.
Dun, 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 dun. Okay.
Are you talking about what happens if you break these laws?
What?
Are you talking about what happens if you break these laws?
Well, I want to keep it on the positive side.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I tend to kind of go, I can go to the negative side.
Okay,
and say,
so
well,
keep it positive. Okay,
keep,
good.
Because we want to look up.
Got it.
Okay, I
all
think
right.
We all come from, we realize what's down. In your gut, you realize what you're doing.
Okay.
And you can
and
say,
you know
okay, you know it's going to happen.
Okay,
right.
Got it.
Okay, and you
can
see
it. We'll keep it positive.
Okay, I don't want to call anyone out. Okay, okay. I want to call everyone up. Okay, all right.
We're not calling out, we're calling up.
We're not calling out, we're calling up.
That's good.
Okay, that's
check.
A good T-shirt.
That is another T-shirt.
I'll write that one down.
Emma,
right.
Write that. Oh, which I want to say hi to Emma, who's our, she's gave a title today. Operations Goddess.
She's Operations Goddess.
She is our Operations Goddess. So everybody say hi to Emma.
All the stuff you see happening behind the scenes.
It's all like, Emma.
It's Emma.
And then, of course, Shelby, who's our producer. But Emma does more of the administrative and creative and all that kind of stuff.
Yep.
So, Emma, write that down. What was the T-shirt?
All right. Not calling you out, calling you up.
There we go. All right. Thanks, Emma.
Okay. All right. All right. The law of action.
Yes.
Okay. This is one we often forget.
Okay.
Okay. Taking action.
Okay.
Okay. You got to take action to be successful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You don't. Inaction leads to failure.
Well, wait. So the law of attraction, though, can't you just sit and think about it? Think about all the things that you want and that you want for your business.
That's
your
called
life.
A dreamer. Being a dreamer.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. An entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Takes action?
Right. Takes action.
Gotcha.
Okay. Takes action.
I'm your straight guy here.
Yeah. Okay. All right. You're keeping pulling it out of me, right? Okay. But it's taking action. Movement. Okay. In fact, you know, what is it? What are we here? What? Movement is life.
Movement is life.
Momente este vita. Right? Is that Latin?
I don't know. Is Janet watching?
Right.
Latin
or Spanish? I don't know. Movement is life. Okay, that's the biggie. You know, the evil behind all of this failure is really evil.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and what's happening in our society? There's a lot of evil happening right now to keep from being active. Mm-hmm. Okay, and to separate.
Well, it's fear.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And all those
You're
kinds of things.
Too scared to go out. Too scared to
right.
do anything.
So
too
we hunker down.
Right.
So we. You know,
don't look at people.
Right.
Right.
And so we hunker down.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we can do that in our business too. Mm-hmm. Okay. We see it happening all the time, and we can make excuses or we can rationalize it. Mm-hmm. Well, it's just not a good time to buy a truck right now because, well, I don't have anyone to put in the truck. Okay. Well, I mean, all
lotion
this
is the lotion of life.
Life. There we go.
That's
lotion.
Really good.
All right. T-shirt.
Okay. Emma, write that one down.
Bo, I'm going to steal that one. Okay. Motion is the lotion of life.
Oh, that's
okay.
good.
That even flows off the very
it
good, Bo.
Well, it's Bo.
All right.
So.
You should be a pastor or a motivational speaker or something. All right.
Faith. Law number one. Without works, the law is dead. Without works. Faith without works is dead.
Yes.
Yes.
There
exactly
we go.
Right. Mm-hmm.
See, all this, Joe, I like it, brother, that what you're leading to.
Mm-hmm.
All this is BC.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not worried about being PC. It's not PC, politically correct, to mention Jesus and that God created the universe, not that some you know, thing happen, which is, how do you believe that? It takes more faith to believe in that kind of stuff, all right?
Yes.
Okay, mm-hmm.
Entrepreneurs versus entrepreneur, exactly right.
Exactly right, yes. Alex. Mm-hmm. But all this stuff was created by God. These laws were created by God, mm-hmm. okay? I mean, so all you got to do it now, well, you, they're simple,
yes.
But with humans, we find it so hard.
It's, well, because we're, I mean, we
they're not
fight
easy,
it.
Right.
Yeah. But BC is, and we're not being politically correct.
We're being biblically correct.
Correct. So,
okay, all this comes
BC,
from.
BC, not PC.
Right. This isn't New Agey.
Emma, that's another one.
I mean, all God created all this. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. And law of action. Mm-hmm. Okay. And everything, you know, faith takes. You know, takes action.
Right.
Okay. Faith without works. Okay. Mm-hmm. You gotta plant a field. Mm-hmm. To believe in the harvest.
Right.
Okay, you can't just sit there and think about it.
Right.
And then blame God. Why God? It's so funny, people don't believe in God and then blame everything. Why does a bad God, you know, why does God let bad things happen?
Right.
God didn't let the bad things happen. Mm-hmm. Bad people, mm-hmm. the people let the bad things happen.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay, like, why is God letting COVID?
God didn't
have anything with COVID. Bad people have created something, weaponized something, mm-hmm. and are using this against us. And we, the people, have allowed it to happen. Mm-hmm. All right.
So go to themilliondollarplumber.com/show when Facebook pulls the plug on us.
All right. So we've got to take action. You got to take action in your business. Mm-hmm. Okay. You
which
gotta,
looks like?
Okay. Buying the truck. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Recruiting?
Recruiting. Mm-hmm. Every day recruiting. Mm-hmm. Well, I can't find anybody.
Today.
Mm-hmm. Right. You got to take the action. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, and first, and it goes to the law of believing that someone wants to work for you, mm-hmm. okay?
Yes.
That there's guys out there. There just aren't any guys out there. Mm-hmm. Are there other plumbing companies out there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, where do they have guys or are they robots? Okay, I mean, there aren't any guys out there.
Ashley Tanner says, we just bought two trucks out of our comfort zone. We just got to move forward with faith. Exactly right. Iron Mountain Plumbing out in
Utah.
It's not St. George, but it's close around there.
Right.
Sorry, I forget every single time. Great company. If anybody, any plumbers are watching in that area, great company to work for.
Right.
Iron Mountain Plumbing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You got to take the action. Action may be, you know, spending the money on the equipment.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Action may be putting processes in place, systems, so that your business will grow.
Right.
And scale.
Right.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All those things.
Action of looking for a shop.
Mm-hmm. It's just not going to fall in your lap.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You got to take action. Mm-hmm. Okay. And the good news is it doesn't take killer action or, you
100%
know,
every day
crushing action.
Right.
I push back against the guy, you know, crush it. No, you don't.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, you know, what built the Grand Canyon. Now, mm-hmm. you know, over time, I mean, just a little, it's amazing how all that adds up.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we don't want to take, you know, 1,000 years to find that new shop.
Right.
But the point I'm trying to get across is, yeah, you don't have to just kill it every single day.
Yeah.
It's bit by bit.
Right.
Okay. Some action, some
positive.
At least
1% every day. Some days may be 10%. Other days may be
right.
one on one.
You go with it. Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and what happens, you create this momentum.
Mm-hmm.
It's a positive forward momentum.
Right.
Okay.
And again, with the law of attraction, you're constantly thinking and focusing on the things that you want, and you literally are then open to things around you that help you get what you want.
I like how Jacob puts mm-hmm. it, being aggressively patient.
Aggressively patient.
Yes.
That's good.
That's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
That is a good one.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Being out there, being patient with the...
What does Ed Milet say?
Dissatisfied.
I'm sorry.
Right.
I wish I...
There's all these kind of good.
There's another one. Andrew says, I will get the shop I'm destined to have. Okay, Andrew, here's a tip for you. Go and start looking for the shop. Get a picture of the shop or the street that it might be on, something to where you can get an actual shop that you can focus on. So you can write in your daily GPS. My shop is at 123 Main Street. You know.
And Andrew, that may sound mm-hmm. weird or mm-hmm. silly or just, you know, whatever.
Right.
But, you know, it's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
or I will have a shop that has, you know, three bays or with, you know, 5,000 square foot or whatever. Start writing those things down.
Right.
And focusing on that.
Right.
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 Being specific. That's the best way to do because it.
Because it's
being
just, very specific. I don't understand the whole, I know these laws are created, and we've been successful because of these laws. And I didn't make this up, and I didn't just decide to do it. I've learned from other successful people.
Correct.
You know, they all kind of revolve around these three things.
Well,
here.
That's, okay. I mean, association. So we're looking at successful people. What did they do to become successful?
Right.
Start studying those people.
Right. And they get down, like the law of attraction, back to the attraction. It isn't just saying I have a shop. Mm-hmm. It's actually having a picture of the shop.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes. It's amazing. Just like when you're plumbing a house or whatever, you know, whatever plumbing you're doing, you know, you just don't say I'm plumbing the house. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're running the plumbing a certain way.
Right.
You know what you're going to do. You can
Correct.
You visualize it. Okay, I got to go from here to here. I need this kind of pipe. I'm going to do this kind of side. Whatever.
Right.
Just you know, for whatever example, you picture it.
Right.
Okay, it's not just I just plumb the house.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's amazing. Just like when you say, well, okay, I got to install this water heater. You don't say I'm going to install a water heater. Well, it's a 50-gallon gas.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
I
need a relief valve. I need a bait. Right, and
right.
I need these kind of connecting materials.
Mm-hmm.
And then those materials come to you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you get those materials.
Right,
you know what to do. Well,
right.
The same thing works with these kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
and Caleb said we just did the same. Two new trucks, two new techs, way out of comfort zone, but got to push forward. That would be full speed ahead, full speed plumbing.
Yes,
right. And then I saw Patrick's comment too, which is Justin Ty's. I should put it back up.
Service man.
Yeah, 615 Plumbing, out of Nashville, Tennessee. Another great plumbing company.
Yep.
There it is. New shop, two new trucks, Ty and Jess doing big things with 615 Plumbing. Absolutely.
Absolutely. And right.
What a great, their truck is just one of my favorites.
Right.
With the dog playing the guitar and the pick, and that was another Dan Antonelli creation.
Yes.
But Full Speed Plumbing just went through a big branding change
as well.
They visualized something. They wanted to make a change.
Okay. You got to visualize these things.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And as soon as you visualize it, if you share it with others, that's when you're gonna have your family and friends and people.
How in the world
right.
are you gonna?
Which leads then to the association,
mm-hmm.
you know, of you know who you associate with, and how you can't just let it, you know, get rid of family.
Right.
I'm not saying get rid of your mom and dad or whatever, but that doesn't mean you need to hang around them.
Right.
Okay.
Constantly.
Right.
Yeah, if they're not supportive, and if they're more toxic.
Which leads then to you know, taking action,
mm-hmm.
and you know I put it up on you know what was the quote
from Napoleon?
Yeah, Napoleon Hill.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Right.
Can't remember what
you
it
know,
was.
That,
but it's on
that
our,
most people
on your
don't fail because they listen to their friends, neighbors, and and family.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that is so
that
true.
Is so true. And that's again
because then what. Because we value that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna cut you,
no,
but we
good.
Because we value what our friends say and what our family say.
Well, it's our circle,
right, and that kind of thing. So then we don't take action on these things.
Mm-hmm.
So
well, they must be right because they don't want me to get hurt and blah blah blah. We're gonna change how the home service customer is served in the Pacific Northwest. Exactly right.
Right.
In and around Anacortes, Washington.
Right.
Love that.
And why not?
Right.
You know?
Right. Exactly. Why not?
Why not? I mean, there was another little, you know, couple guys, you know, a guy who changed the world out of Seattle, Washington,
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
that changed, that saw, you know, that people, everyone could use a computer, you
mm-hmm.
know, and wrote code and all
right.
that and,
mm-hmm.
and programs and
right.
before everyone, you know.
And now look at us.
Now, right.
Yeah. Got to hang with Eagles. And that's
right.
an Eagle saying that right there, Matt Delney.
Right.
Mountaineer Plumbing. All these great plumbing companies join us tonight. Mountaineer Plumbing out of Grand Rapids.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Yeah.
So there we go.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
That's a good one, baby.
Laws
good. Of success.
There's so much
don't
there.
Break them.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, you can use them just like with any law. There's a positive side and a negative side.
Mm-hmm.
You know, atomic power is... You know, on the good side, mm-hmm. you can do great things with it.
Mm-hmm.
On the
nuclear
mm-hmm.
power?
Nuclear power, right.
Mm-hmm.
On the bad side, you
bad
can do some bad things with
mm-hmm.
it. You know, same thing goes with these things. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
What you attract or,
mm-hmm.
you know, what you visualize.
Mm-hmm.
Here, help me out here, okay?
I'm not sure where you're going.
Well, we see with so many guys, you know, this is the biggie thing where what we visualize, I can't be that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you say you can't be that.
Then you won't.
Then you
mm-hmm.
won't, okay?
If you think you can or you think you can't,
right.
you're right.
Right.
Wasn't that Henry Ford?
Yeah.
I believe. If you think you can or if you think you can't, you're right.
Yeah, there we
it's
go.
It's as simple as that.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And it is that simple. And this is so sad.
Mm-hmm.
All right. When you say, well, it just happens to be this time, you know, things are rough. We got COVID and all this stuff. And I just
can't. And you don't know the family I come from.
Right. You don't. Right. Yeah. So it never changes. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right.
Longer before. Thanks, Jordan's.
That's just part about being the law. Thank you. Thank you for the plug.
We love all right. them.
Yeah, we do.
Behney Plumbing out of Mankato.
Right.
Minnesota.
Bay which, Plumbing. Why, you guys are coming down here in
yes,
a week
they
or so.
Are, just over 2 weeks. Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. I saw our boat schedule here. Mm-hmm. Are we going out on boat?
Going out on the boat.
With the Jordans. With all the right. Jordan. We're going to have a good time.
All five Jordans.
All right.
I know. Super exciting.
Looking forward to it. Mm-hmm. Can't wait. We'll have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You'll be good.
But it's.
Kids will be on the boat soon.
Again, you know, what we visualize.
Yes.
Okay, good or bad.
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, who we associate with, mm-hmm. it's a biggie. That's a toughie. Mm-hmm. We see it with our clients all the time. Mm-hmm. I mean, not to throw, you know, it's, look, we all, I you know, my family,
mm-hmm.
I'll throw me under the bus.
Okay.
I mean, my family is like, you know, we don't do this. It's not mm-hmm. where we come from. Mm-hmm. There's not, you don't.
And he said, watch me.
Watch, right.
Hold my beer.
And hold my, that's right. Hold my beer. Hold my beer, you know. And I never saw him again.
Yeah.
I mean, because now I'm the black sheep of the family,
uh-huh.
you know, for being, you know, doing our own thing, right?
Tan. You are tan now.
All right. But you got to take action mm-hmm. then, too. Okay. You can't just dream about it. Sadly,
okay.
I see a lot of that. A lot of dreamers
lot of
out
dreamers.
There. Guys, and I get it. You know, we're visual. You know,
we're visual guys.
Visual guys. Yeah. Right. Okay.
People.
Right.
Most plumbing
okay.
business owners are. They're very dream oriented. Freedom lifestyle, baby.
That's right.
Freedom lifestyle.
Can't wait to hang out.
Hashtag
that's
freedom
right.
lifestyle.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You got to take action, guys. Okay. And you got to take action.
So do it.
Okay. So do it. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Do
one
the.
One way to take action.
One way to take action. Okay. It's a time already. Okay. Very good. Okay. She's reeling me in. All right. One way for you to take action to create the plumbing business that you truly desire. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
One that is successful.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Self-sustaining and very profitable.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Is to join my Million Dollar Plumber Success Academy, all right, where I teach you everything you need to know, okay? All right, I keep you from making all the mistakes I made, okay, from experience, okay? Find the quickest way up your success mountain, okay, and the safest way, all right? But take action. Everything's in there for you. Right now, you can take action. I make it easy for you to take action.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't cost you a thing, all right? 14-day free trial, okay? Check it out for free, 14 days. I'll hook you, okay, if you're truly serious about growing mm-hmm. your plumbing business, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Simply type success in the comments or go to themilliondollarplumber.com/success,
mm-hmm.
all right, to grab your free trial today. Mm-hmm. All right, there we go.
Okay.
All right, good stuff.
Very
I could go on.
Baby.
This is big stuff.
It is.
All right.
Watch that. I think it was a good one.
It's good, okay? Mm-hmm. Think about this, okay? Think about it,
mm-hmm.
all right? All right, law of attraction or law of association, law of action, okay?
Take some action.
All right.
This week.
But, as always, before I let you go, I want to remind you that you were purposely and wonderfully created, and you were created to do great things. All right?
Thank you for tuning in to Potty Talk Live with Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber. If you enjoyed this show, share it now.
Just do it.
To catch past episodes and get alerts for new episodes, turn notifications on now and join us again for more tips, techniques, and strategies to help you grow your plumbing business.